here.
SD was particularly transformative just in, by design, I think. There's just nothing else like sustained dialogue anywhere.
This is like our first approach as an institution to SD, so we're all excited about it. If we could be more open to talk about things that incommodate us and that are different to us, yeah, I mean, it could be helpful, and that's where SD is leading us.
I believe in people. I believe in communication. As a coach of my students, I believe that we need to listen to them in order to create knowledge.
SD gives us the ability to go beyond labels, to go beyond, you know, discussions about systems, and like get to know people on an individual level, and then make the type of change that we need to make so that we can interact with each other more comfortably, more amicably.
In my life now, sustained dialogue, I think that there's a place for it in my workplace and the community that I live in.
Figuring out how to listen well, being taught how to help others connect with each other. I mean, it's useful for kind of any sector that you go into.
How does that impact you and the workplace?
Sustained dialogue has been really good for me and like refreshing in a way to just think about conversations not as I need to convince this person that I'm right, but as I have my own opinion and I come from my own place and these other people have their own opinions and there's not necessarily a right and a wrong.
How did I deal with that? How did I get through that? How did I create empathy and understanding for other people? And the answer that I kept coming back to was sustained dialogue.
We hope that in some ways you'll find some way to take this into your workplaces that infects other people.